Hey, getting a letter from your loved one is so much fun. The postman does not knock at my door. Yet I get all my mails. I don't remember my PIN code.
Because I get all my messages through emails. Let us learn email writing. Can you think of a topic? Okay, I will share a situation with you. When you are writing an email to someone, please remember the following.
The important information should be written in the beginning. We should use simple vocabulary and uncomplicated sentences. Be courteous. Sentences should be grammatically correct. Check for spelling mistakes before submitting. Do not use short forms. End the email with a thanks. Or with a line saying you look forward to hear from the receiver. Write a suitable subject. Subject should begin with capital letter. Like in my birthday party, M is capital.
You are Pearl. Your classmate Vicky is not keeping well since last few days. Write an email caring about his health as well as boosting his morale and giving tips to recover fast.
Dear Vicky, I came to know that you are not able to come to school as you are having fever since the last few days. Are you feeling better now? You may be having some common viral infection of the nose or throat. Please drink plenty of fluids, as fever can cause fluid loss and dehydration. Hope you are taking adequate rest in order to recover fast. Keep checking your temperature using a thermometer. Eat easily digestible food like khichdi, dalia, upma, etc. Use warm water to take bath. Also, take your medicines regularly. You can read some comics or storybooks like Panchatantra during the day to keep your mind happy. Hope you are talking to your doctor regularly and giving him or her updates about your symptoms and recovery. Please do not worry or cry. You will get well soon. We are praying for you in school. Your absence makes me sad. I long to see you back in school. With sound health, so that we can play our favorite games together. You are missed by many here. I will help you with class notes and homeworks that you have missed during these days. So take care, dear friend, and know that we are eagerly waiting for your return. I look forward to hearing from you soon. Love, Pearl.
This was quite an emotional one. That is why we say, friendship is like the cement that will ever hold the world together. This is the format of writing an email. An email has these important fields like the date, the email ID of the sender, the email ID of the receiver, the subject. The subject should be brief, giving an idea about the content. Like, in this case, it can be sending my wishes for your good health and some tips for your recovery. After the subject, we have the salutation like, dear ma'am, dear sir, dear friend, dear Kritika, name of the friend, etc. Then we write the content, the body of the email. The last part is the complimentary clause. Here you can write regards with love, love, followed by your name in the next line. An email also has these options like to send the email, to keep as a draft, to save, to delete the email, or to attach files, pictures, documents to the email. Here I would like to ask you a question. Have you ever thought that the content of the email can be used in the informal letter as well? See, only the format is different. The body or the content is the same which you write to a friend in a letter or in an email. The format of the informal letter is not very different. We begin with writing the sender's address, which should be limited to 3 lines. After writing the address, leave space and write the date, current date. Follow the format, date, name of the month, year. Before writing the letter, there's a salutation which can be like dear mother, dear sister, friend, etc. The body of the informal letter has 3 parts. First is the introduction, which can be any general message. Second is the main part of the letter. It should have the description as per the question or the requirement or the purpose of writing the letter. The last is the conclusion, the concluding or the end part of the letter. In this case, Pearl writes to Vicky, "So take care, dear friend, and know that we are eagerly waiting for your return and hearing from you soon." The subscription at the end of the letter usually ends with "Your lovingly, yours truly, etc." Please note, the first letter Y is capital. Then comes the name of the sender below the subscription. In an informal letter, only the first name is written. Like, if the full name is Pearl Bathman, we write only Pearl, the first name. So, now you know to write an email, and you also know to write a letter, an informal letter. Has some do's and don'ts. I have already told you some of them. Let's recapitulate. 1. Address should be in 3 lines. I have mentioned this before. Never put your name before the address. First, the address comes. 3. Use capital Y in yours and lovingly should be in small l. Don't use comma after salutation and subscription. No commas here and there. 5. Don't use apostrophe in yours. This is really important. 6. Use relevant ideas. Express them in coherent and organized manner. Be accurate, specific. The date should be written under the last line of the address. Please remember to leave a little space between the date and the address. I have already shown you the format of the day. Here is another example. Now we have come to the end of the video. All this content is for free. Before you go, please note my email ID in the description below. Write a letter to me. Formal, informal, I don't mind. Just write. We are a team of only 2 members, a mother and a daughter. And what more do we need to create more such videos? We need your likes, your comments, your subscription. We thank you for watching our video. You will find a series of videos on the same topic, email and informal letter writing. each time with a different topic. I hope you will check them too. Till then, please take care. Goodbye. Thank you for watching.